So I thought we'll take the opportunity of talking anything that you wish. I don't have anything specific, but it's a good time to ask, to say what you learned, what you didn't learn, where your doubts are, where the problems are, any areas you would like to explore. We have about an hour, so it's a free time. We can talk about anything under the sun. We can discuss questions, you can share your experience, anything you like, wherever it goes. Anything that you, that impressed you, that you learned, or you can say, then I can add something to whatever you already know, maybe, or something to ask, or any area of homeopathy or general, anything, there are no limits. Anything that comes to you spontaneously. Oh.
Sir, a bit of insight into spirituality.
Insight into spirituality?
Yeah.
My God.
A bit.
A bit?
Yeah.
How much? Ankle deep, knee deep, thigh deep, or full immersion?
Full immersion.
Full immersion, that way. Well, spirituality. See, the World Health Organization, it describes health as a physical, mental and a spiritual well-being. It's a definition. We understand what is the physical well-being when your organ systems are functioning normally, your energy is good, your functioning is good, your pathological parameters are good. The physical well-being. We know what is the mental well-being when you feel in balance. You are not thinking or behaving abnormally. You are not ridden with anxiety, fear, anger, guilt, sadness. You are not fixed on one thing. You are feeling mentally at peace. It's a mental well-being. Then what is a spiritual well-being? This is a subject that people do not talk about much, especially not in medical colleges, even though spiritual well-being is a part of World Health Organization definition of health, but nobody even discusses it. That is a bit of a, you can say, lacuna in our education and in our practice. So in this way, we have to understand what is spiritual well-being. Spiritual well-being is, you can say, in a way, knowing yourself as a part of something bigger than you. We often think ourselves as only individual. My health, my body, my mind. But we have to also see ourselves in context of creation. Because this body and mind is a temporary, is limited in time and space. So we can choose to see ourselves as this limited time-space entity that lasts for maximum of 100 years, that occupies so much space only, and that interacts with other things. This is all we are. It is possible. But to be able to see that this limited entity is actually a part of a much larger existence. This is a spiritual well-being. Most of us don't give thought to it. Often the only time we give thought to it is when we attend to a funeral. So when the body is burning, we think, life is temporary. We have all to come, we are all to go. But when we turn back from the funeral, we start discussing the stock market. Which stock I should buy? Everything is left behind there only. So when we view life from the viewpoint of death, that yes, after some time, shorter or longer, I think in about, who is the youngest person here, maybe 25, 30, maybe. So after 70 years, none of us are going to be here, yes or no? Hopefully not. Who wants to live after 100? Not too many people. None of us going to be here. So we are only temporary guests on this planet. And yet, we want to own more and more property. One rich fellow will be there, he has got 100 acres, now he wants 200 acres, he has got 2 houses, he wants 10 houses, 20 factories, 30 cars. And everybody want to aspire like this. Bill Gates is a big ideal, or whoever it may be. And also, not only wealth-wise, but also ego-wise. I want to be famous, more famous, powerful, more powerful. If you want a perfect example, it would be Donald Trump. In today's day and age. He represents what one would call the height of materialistic ambition, no? It's not enough for him. He wants to be president, he is president, he has got God knows how many properties and how many businesses, women as well, no? At least officially I think it was 280, I don't know unofficially how many. So I want more. So when you aspire more, so suppose you have, let's say, in crores we will count 100 crore, 200 crores, 500 crores. What you are going to do? After 5 minutes you are dead, no credit card company is going to give you credit, no? Yes or no? You know any? You can take the card with you also. No. So there's another side that says, what you are doing all this for? You are just a temporary being. You are created from the elements. From dust you came and to dust you will go. This is spirituality. To be aware of this is spiritual health. Just to be aware. What does that awareness do? It balances you. And then it tells you that you are here as a part of creation to fulfill a certain role, do the role to the best of your ability, and leave with a smile. You think Trump will leave with a smile? No. He'll say, I'm losing, my God, everything is going from me. He will struggle. But the man who wanted nothing in the first place, he is very happy to go. Well, end of this journey. I have reached my destination. This is a spiritual health. And this spiritual health balances your emotions, your ambitions, your expectations, and makes you want to give rather than to grab. Uska bhi main chheen lo. What he has, I will take from him. I'll take, I'll exploit, I'll do this, I'll do that. What you will do? In 1 minute you are dead. What are you going to do? Take as much as you need and give as much as you can. So spirituality leads to that kind of attitude. And when you don't want anything for yourself, your stress levels comes down. Do you follow? I am teaching you now, right? I work in other song 4 days in a week. 4 days is what you see me working. I work another 4 days when you don't see me working. Meetings after meetings after meetings. This thing, that thing, so many things going on all the time. What do I get out of it? Materially nothing. In fact, I lose. As head of other song academy, do you know what is my salary? Any thought? Give a rough guess. What do you think? Some thought you must have. Take a guess. Don't smile. 50,000. Yeah, I get nothing. Zero. Yeah. Because I have enough, no. I have enough what I need for my food and drink, I have. No, not to reach, it is just awareness, what I am going to take with me. So if I have enough, I don't need more. What other song will give me that I don't have? I don't need. So what can I do? How can I contribute to homeopathy, to creating better homeopath, to creating health for the world? This is my intention. So I have no personal need or greed coming here. And therefore I have no tension. I am not losing anything. Even the academy goes away, I lost nothing. In fact, I gained a lot of free time and holidays. So when I don't have a personal greed or a need, my stress levels are very, very low. So I do it out of a sense of fulfilling my role and out of a sense of enjoyment, not out of a sense of a personal need. I want power, I want this, I want money, I don't want anything. All my needs are fulfilled. I am content. How to be aware? Go to the funerals again and again. Every 2 days visit a funeral. I do that in my mind all the time. I constantly aware that after I am dead, after 3 minutes, they are going to call me the body. You won't call me sir at that time. You won't say sir is lying there. You say the body is here. Body, shift the body from here to here. Put the body in the pyre, let the body go. So what happened to all my money, my name, my power, my position? Nothing. So is that what I have to live for? Doesn't make sense to me. So by this awareness, it balances. It's not I am a saint or, you know, I have no ego or no greed or no need. Nothing like that. I also have, but it gets balanced by this. Till I am human, I will have needs, no? I still think I'll eat pani puri in the evening. Need is there. Temptations are there. If somebody gives me my wife came from Dubai airport. She says, what can I get you? I looked on the internet, what can I buy in Dubai airport? Then it is written, there's a raffle. If you put 100 dirhams or something, you can win a car, one of those. I said, get me one lottery ticket. So I'm also thinking, maybe I'll win a nice car. What's wrong with that? But I'm not attached to it. If I win, good. If I don't win, okay, no issue. Age related. I ask Donald Trump. He's older than me. I'm not sure it is fully age related. Eh? How was my state? I have written in my book. You read now. Have you read my book, Dog Yogi? I have written my whole life story in it. I also had lot of desire for, doing something great, winning Nobel Prize, coming to. My aim was less money, but more about creativity and about doing something remarkable, changing the world, and making a name for myself, becoming very famous, not just famous, but famous for having done something. Yeah, earth shattering. Ego needs were there. So ego at young age, you need to prove yourself. It's very important that you feel good about yourself, that you are something worthy of something. This is a very important need in human being. As much as need for relationship, as much as need for security, as much as need for financial security, as much as need for friends and peer group. So these are psychological, biological needs also. There are many such needs that are natural. You have to go through those stages. But at all stages, see, at my stage, it's very important for people to have a very big position and power and this and that. You know, they graduate from fourth row to fifth row of periodic table to sixth row. They need position in society, you know. Why I'm a big man. So many needs. But underlying all the stages of life, if there is a spiritual awareness, yes, I am going through this stage at a human level, but behind that is the reality of your spiritual being. You have to balance. It balances you at every stage in life. And this kind of spiritual awareness, I believe it's very important for all the physicians to have within themselves and to be able to convey that to the patient. To be able to give not only guidance physically, emotionally, but also spiritually. And not only give guidance, but also become role models in that sense. And to share with their patients or students in your case, this journey. Because it's a process. It's not suddenly you become enlightened. So this sharing of this process is very important. I share with all my patients who need it, not everybody. But I tell them my own story, if necessary. And that's why I wrote that book, Dog Yogi Banyan Tree. Because each chapter addresses a kind of an obstacle towards greater spirituality. So there are problems with friendship, with relationship, with money, with ambition, with whatever. So how do you overcome that? That's the journey. And ultimately, there are many ways to reach to that spiritual thing. One is called satsang. Satsang means, sat is truth, sang means company. So in the company of the truth, that means when you listen to people who have achieved a certain level of spiritual awareness, that is satsang. By reading what they wrote or reading their life story, how did they behave, how did they talk, how did they walk, the autobiography or the writings or the biography of certain enlightened beings. This is satsang. And their words are very, very important. It comes from a very, very pure place. And what does that mean? When somebody says, Vaishnava jana to tene kahiye je peed parai jane re, what does it mean? It means, the man of God is he who understands or knows the suffering of the other person, and he helps the suffering person, but without any sense of pride. Mana abhimana na ane re. How you can help somebody and not feel, oh, I helped him? It's only possible when you see him as yourself. There's no other way. So they are giving you the signs, the symptoms of an enlightened being. So to read these words, you know, Vaishnava Janato, do you know? You know? Who can sing? Anybody? Somebody will know how to sing this, no? You know? I sing? Oh, single line, okay. You start, it'll start, don't worry.
वैष्णव जन तो तेरे कहिए जे पीर पराई ना
जाने रे
जाने रे पर दुखे उपकार करे तो ये मन अभिमान ना जाए रे.
Very good. You learned singing or what?
So my father used to put it in
your
our
father.
Home, yeah.
Yeah. Learn. Perfect it. This is what you are singing is this rag is called Khamaj. And it goes like this. Vaishnava jana to tene kahiye Vaishnava jana to tene kahiye je peeda parai jaane re Vaishna वजन तो तेने रे कहिए जे पीड़ा पराई जाने रे पर दुखे उपकार करे तो ये पर दुखे उपकार करे तो ये मन अभिमानन आने रे वैष्णव वजन तो तेनी कहिए जे सकल लोकमा सौने वंदे निंदा न करे के नीरे वाचकाच मन निश्चल राखे वाचकाच मन निश्चल राखे धन धन जननी तेनी रे वैष्णव वजन तो तेनी कहिए जे लर्न एंड देन लर्न द वॉइस ऑफ कबीर कबीर इज ऑल्सो अ ग्रेट स्पिरिचुअलिस्ट What he wrote is unbelievable. And he wrote, Kabira, jab tum paida hue, sab hase, tum roe. You understand? When you were born, everybody is smiling, you are crying. Aisi karni kar chalo. Do such actions in your life, tum hase, Sab roe. When you go, you smile, everybody else cries. So beautiful, no? Why do you smile? Because every moment of your life, you have lived full and given. Nothing to regret. Going is happiness. Who is the one who cries when he goes? Arre, I didn't get this, I didn't get that, I didn't get this. Arre, I'm going, I didn't get anything. So many unfulfilled wishes. He'll cry, no, when he goes. The man who has lived his life from spirituality, he will smile when he goes. That is the sign. Kabira jab tum paida huve jaga से तुम रोए ऐसी करनी कर चलो तुम हंसे जग रोए सत्संग मीन्स Just listening to these people and you get a completely different orientation of life.